introduce, right here is Tim Eckstein. He's the chief of police here in Gas City. To my left, John Neergardner, Corporal John Neergardner from the Indiana Department of Natural Resources, and Chief Deputy Grant County Prosecutor Evan Hammond is also here today. Unfortunately, this morning at approximately 3 a.m., a four-day search for missing 10-year-old Skyla Carmack has come to a tragic end. Skyla's body was located in a shed behind her Gas City home. She was hidden inside a plastic trash bag. This morning, Amanda Carmack, 34 years of age, the stepmother of Skyla, was arrested for Skyla's murder. She also faces charges for neglect of a dependent, resulting in death, domestic battery, resulting in death, and strangulation, all felony charges. She is currently incarcerated in the Grant County Jail. Very preliminary evidence indicates Skyla was killed approximately between the hours of 4:30 p.m. and 6 p.m. on Saturday, August the 31st. Again, emphasizing preliminary evidence indicates young Skyla was strangled. But as normal protocol in cases like this, an autopsy will be conducted to verify her cause of death. The Indiana State Police was assisted by multiple law enforcement agencies, fire departments, and community volunteers during this search for Skyla. The various agencies provided equipment, manpower, intelligence gathering, and a host of other needed resources in an effort to find her. There are too many to list in a press conference, but their assistance would greatly appreciate it. Gas City, Grant County is an area that cares, an area that loves. They wanted to bring this young lady home safely, but unfortunately, those aren't the results we got. At this time, I'll answer any questions that you have.
How was Skyla initially reported?
She was reported by her stepmother missing to the Gas City Police Department in person. And that was on Saturday at approximately 9 p.m.
And she preliminarily been interviewed as to why?
I am sure those questions have been asked, but as you know, in law enforcement, our main focus is who and how, not why. I mean, to try to rationalize why someone would kill a 10-year-old, there's no rationale for that. It's just an act of cowardice.
Now, did she actually confess to this? Is that what spurred on the specific search?
Well, evidence led us to her. As far as confessions, that's not something I'm authorized to release. We do not want to have a court hearing here in the public spectrum, but we did have evidence to get probable cause to make an arrest this morning.
And you believe she's the only one involved, or do you believe there is someone else?
At this time, we believe she is the only one involved. We have no other suspects at this time. There's a conglomerate of evidence that came to the conclusion, but there is evidence, obviously, to make probable cause to charge her with murder and other charges as it relates to the death of Skyla. As far as a particular piece, we're obviously not going to release that today in a press conference.
Have police ever been called to this home before?
I'm not aware of that.
Domestic issues? No.
For any other reason, drug issues?
No. There was a call in regards to a juvenile and a theft. But anything far as a family disturbance or a altercation within the home regarding family, no, there had not been.
Was there a prior search done before this recent one? Had you checked the home or the shed?
It had been checked before, but you got to remember at the time she was reported missing, we're looking for a little girl. We had no reason to believe that she had been murdered at that time. So it had been checked before, and we're going to look into that and obviously that was part of our investigation to recheck everything we had done previously, unfortunately, until we found her deceased.
Were there six other kids in the home?
Six plus Skyla, so there were seven total.
Falls in age range?
I believe the oldest was 13. I do not know what the youngest.
She's right in the middle. There's right a 13 and yeah. Three 10-year-olds.
They've been taken into the custody of Child Protective Services, so that's where we stand on that. Any questions related to that particular situation as far as the children has to be referred to the Indiana Department of Child Services here in Grant County.
Do you know when she'll be in court for her first appearance?
I do not.
We don't have the formal charges filed yet today. Hoping to get those done today. I would say within a couple of days of that.
Yeah, we're less than. Yeah, we're less than 12 hours into this, so.
What was the father, Kevin Cormack's reaction to the news when he found out?
Well, I imagine he was devastated. I wasn't there when the news was presented, but I know he was concerned that this could be an outcome. And unfortunately, as a parent, your worst nightmare comes true when a child doesn't, you entrust someone to protect, allegedly ends up being someone that causes them harm, maybe even their death.
A lot of agencies that were involved in the search. Was it one agency that was there at 3 a.m. that found them, or was there a group of agencies that were there?
From the beginning, since it was reported to the Gas City Police Department, they requested assistance from the Indiana State Police. It's been a multi-agency, not just law enforcement, but also volunteer firemen, any other resource you could think of to help assist in finding this young lady. Like I said, this community cared. They wanted to find this young lady safe, but I don't know exactly how many officers were there. Obviously, the Indiana State Police was involved when the young lady was found.
Are there any details you can release about how ultimately the person who has been arrested for this crime initially reported Skyla missing? Did she just say she ran away, just didn't come home? Do you know the details of that?
Well, she said that Skyla was missing and didn't know where she had gone, as far as I understand it. I mean, that's basically it. She reported her missing and didn't know where she was, and that started everything that occurred in the last 4 to 5 days.
Just didn't come home from school?
Well, she was homeschooled, so obviously that wasn't an issue. She went missing from the residence. That's where she was last seen alive, so that's where we started. I don't know how, I mean, it has happened in the past, not in any case I've been involved with in my 20 years of law enforcement, but nothing surprises you in this job anymore, or me anyway. So again, it's a heartbreaking case to lose a 10-year-old life from this community. I know all the people, the hundreds of people that participated in the search to find this young lady are devastated. Even though we knew as time went by the odds of finding her safe were not in our favor, we tried to remain optimistic, and we put every resource that we have, not just with the Indiana State Police, but the Indiana Department of Natural Resources. We've had people from other communities volunteering drones and canines for the search. We're devastated. We're sad, and but we're glad that allegedly the person who committed the crime of killing Skyla is in custody.
Had there been any attempt to hide the body? I mean, how, any kind of concealment?
Well, it was hidden in a trash bag, so I would call that an attempt to hide the body, and then placed into a shed behind the home. So yes, there was an attempt to do that.
Was there any prior child abuse that was alleged?
That's an issue for the Department of Child Services. As far as I know, the information I know I can't release, and that'd be better served by going through them. They would have that information.
Were the kids taken to Child Services this morning, or had they been previously?
I believe they were taken over the weekend during the course of the investigation. But again, you would have to confirm that through the Department of Child Services.
What's your message to anyone who allegedly get this far that they would do this to a child?
I can't wrap my mind around why you would kill a 10-year-old child. I said it earlier, it's just an act of cowardice. If you find yourself in that state of anger or whatever precipitated this event, step away. Do whatever you have to do to regain your composure. But it's just mind-boggling to me that anyone could injure or even and eventually kill a young child, only 10 years of age. That's all I got. I mean, it's just heartbreaking, and I see no reason why this should have occurred. Okay, no more questions. We'll go ahead. We'll go ahead and conclude now. I appreciate you guys covering. Right before we end, I want to make sure I thank this community. They wrapped their arms around this investigation and provided not just resources to help us out, but they also provided boots on the ground. There were people volunteering their own time to search wooded areas and wherever they thought this young lady might be. Unfortunately, it didn't come to fruition as we wanted it to. But it wasn't from a lack of trying. I also would like to thank the media who covered this event. You guys are an integral part in helping us get the message out to find what we were hoping to find, Skyla alive. And you did your part to help us out, and we greatly appreciate that. And I appreciate you covering this story. So thank you very much. That concludes our press conference. And again, change that 12:14 to 3 a.m.